बिस्मिल्लाह रहमान रहीम, हिज एक्सीलेंसी मिस्टर वोल्कान बोस्के, फॉरेन मिनिस्टर ऑफ पाकिस्तान, मिनिस्टर्स, पार्लियामेंटेरियंस, लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन, वी वेलकम द प्रेसिडेंट ऑफ द यूनाइटेड नेशंस जनरल असेंबली टू पाकिस्तान. एंड इट हैज बीन अ वेरी एन एरा ऑफ टर्मोइल इन द पास्ट फ्यू मंथ्स एट लीस्ट एज फार एज पैलेस्टाइन वॉज कंसर्न. And we have felt, and the voices of the Ummah, as well as the voices of the people, the just voices of the people, have been raised in the General Assembly. And I must congratulate the President of the General Assembly for ensuring the fact that despite the Security Council not responding with even a statement, the voice of the oppressed was heard in the General Assembly. And that is where Pakistan made sure that there is a ceasefire. There is a discrepancy in world thinking when disproportionate reactions take place, where only 5 Israelites or 20 are killed, and at the same time the bombardment kills 230 or 200 plus Palestinians. We must recognize, the world must recognize, a disproportionate reaction. For example, if I give you a figure that 5 people were killed on one side and 1,000 were killed on the other side just in reaction, so that will be a very bad figure. But that has happened in the world. So therefore, in our discussions a few minutes before we came for the ceremony, I was talking about the fact that the hope with the United Nations has been there. Palestine is burning, Kashmir is burning, and we have been looking towards the United Nations to fulfill its own promises made in the 50s with the Kashmiri people. And if there is no choice left, these people then, the suppressed, turn towards violence, which we abhor at the same time, but we feel that there must be openings towards peace for the downtrodden people whose land has been occupied. So there's an opportunity in Palestine for a two-state solution. But ultimately, what is a two-state solution? I believe very strongly that the majority should be governing the country or the land, wherever it is. But even if it is a two-state solution, the opportunity to go towards a two-state solution is in a few years, and then things, the situation in Palestine, if you look at the last 20, 30, 40 years, it has continuously gone down. The same thing has happened in Kashmir. The situation has never improved. It has gone worse. The occupation is legitimized. Demographic changes are brought in. So we have a lot of hope with the United Nations, and I think the United Nations and this era of recognition of nation states started from the Westphalian Order, which we talked about, and which was a result of 30 years' war and 80 years' war. And the hope was that when we provide security to the nation states, there will be peace. On the other hand, what we see today, international institutions based on vested interests, international institutions not based on morality. And I'm proud of the fact to mention that in the early era of the Muslims, there were institutions which were based on morality, and we look forward to an international era which is based on morality. So I don't want to speak too long, because we'd like to hear your words, and I thank you for visiting Pakistan, and Pakistan continues to play an important role in the United Nations, reflecting what its nation thinks about Kashmir. We are very emotional people. So what we think about Kashmir and what we think about Palestine, we would like to be a strong advocate, and as the Prime Minister has said, that he's the strongest advocate as far as Kashmir is concerned, to let the international community know what is pain. Today, with the social media, news cannot be suppressed. Anti-Zionism, anti-Israel statements are sometimes construed to be anti-Semitic. We are not anti-Semitic people. The Muslims have never been anti-Semitic, and therefore we believe the atrocities committed, an apartheid state created in Palestine, is very painful to us. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen.
Mr. President, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, I feel honored tonight on behalf of myself my country, but for the United Nations, for the award you have decided to give to me. I think United Nations, whether liked or not, is the biggest democratic and worldwide operating institution. Of course, success is the key. Every politician, businessman, sportsperson, bureaucrat must be successful. And unfortunately, in the last few years or perhaps decades, there wasn't a lot of success stories for the United Nations. And this has brought down the expectation from the United Nations. I shouldn't say loss of credibility, but the expectation. One journalist in New York mentioned that in previous years, when hot issues were debated in the United Nations, every channel of the world was represented by one journalist. Now they said one is covering three or four channels. And why? Because the world wants hot issues, fights, quarrels, solutions, messages being presented there. And if it is becoming monotonous, then the attraction of the press, which means the attraction of the people on the street, goes to other directions. So I think what we have achieved last week, thanks to the leadership of Pakistan and all the ministers coming to New York, is showing something different than what the people are used to see. People are looking at the United Nations saying that Security Council will block everything in the end with one veto or two vetoes, whatever. And so we can't expect a solution from the United Nations. But what we have shown that while the United Nations Security Council was blocked and the Secretary General was not able to act because the Security Council was not giving any instructions, the General Assembly suddenly convened, and without a resolution, we reached the people of the world with strong messages, and from me an appeal for peace declaration, first time in the GA history that the President took that possibility, and it will be used from now on. And we show that there is another institution, an organ in the United Nations that can also come into the surface and give good results. It also happened when the capital was decided to be moved from Tel Aviv to Jerusalem. It was because of the General Assembly that it was stopped. So we can stop wrong things or initiate good things. And I think this meeting, the ministers coming, flying for 40 hours, 30 hours, 20 hours, taking the burden, going back to their countries, will always be remembered. It was an historic event. And I know that, Mr. President, yourself, the Prime Minister, was here, but the Foreign Minister was taking the leading role. I was a witness of that. And I think in a dinner before the meeting took place, he invited all the ministers. And there, the best way of handling the General Assembly meeting was decided. And it was a very civilized meeting. Everybody gave their messages. Everybody listened to the other messages. And I think it was a very good performance. I think from now on, there are 193 countries in the world. All of them are, we have to respect. But there are countries with a capacity to make some difference. And I think Pakistan is one of them. And we're expecting a lot from the leadership of Pakistan for the Afghanistan issue and Jammu Kashmir issue. I think if the proper time, appropriate time is found, sometimes 5 years is too short to solve a problem, and sometimes 2 days is too long if you miss that opportunity. So we must wait for the right moment and do the right movement and try to make history in all the issues we are living with for more than 50 years now. And I thank again for this wonderful dinner and also the honor you have given to me. I wish Pakistan to be forever in glory, in peace and security.